Williams came to New Orleans in 1939 in order to reinvent himself. He wanted to escape the pressures of his family and wanted a more fun lifestyle than the one he had in Iowa. The first place he lived in New Orleans was 722 Toulouse Street, just off of Bourbon. When I first came here, I was Thomas Lanier Williams. I then started to experiment with different names, of one of them being Valentine Xavier. But on reflection, I thought it seemed a bit pompous. So then I settled on the name Tennessee Williams, which I remained for the rest of my life.
Always said there's only three cities in America: New York, San Francisco, and the city of New Orleans.
The New Orleans-St. Charles streetcar line is the oldest continuing street railway system in the world. The streetcar line is the earliest form of public transportation in New Orleans. The streetcar line started with the Carrollton Railroad Company in 1835. They were updated to be electrically powered on February 1, 1893. In 1890, laws were passed requiring segregation of the streetcars. This segregation was rejected initially by all races, as it was an inconvenience to the riders and difficult to determine race in New Orleans. Tennessee Williams' play, A Streetcar Named Desire, was written in 1947. The Desire streetcar line was started in the 1920s and converted to a bus line in 1948. Throughout the 1940s, the residents along the lines complained about the noise and the mess the streetcars made, triggering the change in the streetcar. By April 1948, the play had gained popularity, and the residents along the Desire line changed their minds because of the rising popularity of the line due to the play. But the streetcar line was removed and replaced in May.
My friends always ask me why I keep coming back to New Orleans. I tell them it's my spiritual home, the last frontier of Bohemia. At 632 and a half St. Peter Street, during the years of 1946 to 48, when I wrote A Streetcar Named Desire here, I was often inspired by the skylight on the third floor.
Because of the diversity and acceptance of sexuality and race in New Orleans, and specifically the French Quarter, Williams included many ethnicities into his plays. The locations where he lived also influenced his writing. Living in an apartment similar to Stella and Stanley's would help him portray the intimacy of the house. When he lived on 632 and a half St. Peter Street, he was very close to Royal Street, and the Desire route could even be seen from his apartment.
Any one particular scene or character resonate with you?
Oh, well, all of them, but I do have a lot of favorite lines. And this is going to be very appropriate for right here. And it's Blanche says it, and she's talking about New Orleans. She says, "Don't you just love these long, rainy afternoons in New Orleans, where an hour is not an hour, but a little piece of eternity dropped into your hand?" Nice, huh?
Yeah. And then, what do you know about his legacy or his impact on New Orleans? And are there any particular ways that this affects you, or you see this in the bookstore?
Oh, well, you know, all the writers were here in the 20s and 30s and 40s, and then New Orleans was always, Tennessee called it his spiritual home. So it was very important to him. And the major reason it was important to him is because it offered him freedom to be as he wanted to be, so.
Put on a mink coat and come out and throw the mink coat on the side of the pool. or give it to your manservant and let him come to the pool. He lived up on the second floor up there. But he bought this place long after he wrote Streetcar.
Right. Yeah, he wrote 20 years. War. It was 20 years after.
Oh.
Right. Yeah, he wrote Little Wars. And he sits like that plaque out there and says he wants to be buried in his old grass bed.
First home I was able to buy with my own money. After the success of Streetcar, I was fortunate enough to be able to purchase it. Only place I actually lived in that was my own. A lot of times I'd like to swim in this pool every day of the year.
A little interview of y'all.
Would y'all would allow it?
Who the hell?
No, I'm not too much on the interview.
It's just this little short question. Y'all don't have to do it though, too.
He'll do it.
What's the question?
You had a question.
Well, I was just wondering, did Tennessee Williams' life at this house in particular impact your decision to move here?
No. We saw him coming back in 83 to do some minor repair work, getting ready to sell it. And we got in touch with him. Went from there, by the bottom of her.
From Tennessee Williams?
Yes.
Wow.
Oh, how was he? That's so, what was he like a person?
Met him two or three times. He was very quiet, laid back. Not quite what you hear about some of his past lifestyles, previous lifestyles. But, he's very, very pleasant, very easy to deal with.
Had you read his plays before moving in?
I've seen a few of them, but I sure read them on the theater.
Tennessee Williams has made a huge impact on the city of New Orleans. There's an annual 5-day festival to commemorate him and help his legacy to continue to impact the city of New Orleans and the literary world. During this festival, there's a contest held in Jackson Square for who can bellow Stella the best. In one interview, a woman told us how impactful this contest was to her through her Katrina. Instead of screaming Stella, the winning contestant turned to the north and screamed FEMA. This festival has brought New Orleans together in good times and bad, and keeps Tennessee Williams' legacy alive and well today.
A friend of mine has some letters and drawings that they did.
Tennessee Williams frequented Galatoire's restaurant, choosing to eat at a table facing Bourbon Street to watch the happenings of the city and to be inspired. During the Tennessee Williams Festival every year, Galatoire's restaurant auctions off reservations for his table to fans of his plays and poetry. They come to be inspired by the same views and fine dining which he was many years ago. Another one of his favorite spots was Brennan's Restaurant. He proclaimed his love for Bananas Foster, Brennan's signature dessert. Williams also frequented Marty's Restaurant on the corner of Domain and Rampart Streets. This restaurant has now been permanently closed. Williams stayed at a number of hotels on his numerous visits to New Orleans. He primarily frequented the Hotel Monteleone, which today has a luxury suite named in his honor. I hope to die in my sleep, in this beautiful big brass bed in my New Orleans apartment, the bed that is associated with so much love.